Hey folks, I just wanted to share with you something funny. Let's see.
Thank you for not wearing masks. I know you're not vaccinated, so I appreciate you doing that shit. Are y'all vaccinated or not? You are?
Oh.
Which one? You got the black one, Medea, right? Why'd you get vaccinated? Are you a doctor or something like that? What's your job? Which prison? Was that where Ghislaine Maxwell was? Yeah, I was asleep. Yeah, we...
Fucking genius. I mean, you probably know Andrew Schultz, but if you did not, watch him.
We heard that before. Oh, I fell asleep, and then I just got a brand new house in Long Island for some reason. I fell asleep. What a shame. And if you see them like each other, do you don't stop it, or what do you do? You hear it though. You hear motherfuckers screaming. Put your fucking AirPods on. Do not disturb. Help! I told you long ago, on the road, I got what they're waiting for.
Nice.
Got that Lil Nas X pumping while that dude got that Lil Nas X pumping, bro. Black people.
Fucking genius.
We made a bot too.
We are about to be at war with Russia, folks. It could happen any day now. Russia is threatening to invade the Ukraine, and America is threatening to kill all of them. In retaliation, Putin said, quote, "We will start a war that nobody will win." Thank you. Finally, someone addresses the elephant in the room. They've got nukes. We've got nukes. Let's use some of them. Why not? Lob a few at Los Angeles, Vladdy. Start with that pink Instagram wall and then Flappers Comedy Club. We are officially Team Putin. He said, "Oh, you motherfuckers want the smoke? We'll give it to you." We are about to be at war with...
You motherfuckers want that smoke? We'll give it to you. Yeah, nice.
I wish I had known that this too shall pass. You feel bad right now? You feel pissed off? You feel angry?
Yes,
this
good.
Too shall pass.
Oh, great.
You feel great? You feel like you know all the answers?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You feel like that everybody finally gets you there you are?
Yeah.
This too shall pass.
Ooh, good.
Time is your ally, and if nothing else, just wait.
Just wait.
Just wait it out. I wish I had known that this too shall pass.
Hashtag true story, folks.
Hey, yo. I got a beautiful wife, kids, and a gorgeous home. What would make me jump in the tub with a cordless phone? I'm straight vicious. I hit you with plates and dishes. Leave you with 8 stitches. When I'm gay because I hate bitches? Slut, don't be nice to me. I've had it with girls, and I'll still be mad at the world, even if it apologized to me. You're hearing the last thoughts of a man about to blow his fucking brains out and fall back on a bloodstained blouse on top of his spouse spread out on a bloodstained couch in front of his kids that he just killed in the same house. I'm sickening boy George, picturing Michael Jackson in little boy's drawers shopping at toy stores. If Shady said it, Shady meant it. I stayed a minute. I'll throw a stroller at you with a baby in it. Go ahead, pull the plug. Think I won't slap you. I just dropped the fucking pill, Mom. Don't vacuum.
White kids are just as shocked to find out black kids don't talk back to their parents as we are, and we hear them talk back to theirs. So I used to have a little buddy would come over my house on the weekends.
Wait, who was it? Ah, Eris Spears, okay.
Little Nate.
I've watched that special, but this is a little bit a few years ago.
We'd be in my room playing video games. My mother used to come in the room on us, cuss me out for no reason. We'd be in the room playing Mario Brothers. She'd come kick open the door like SWAT. Harris, how many times have I told you to clean this motherfucking room? Cut that goddamn game off to clean this room. I come back, this motherfucking room ain't clean. I'm gonna take that Nintendo cord, wrap it around your neck, and stick it in your ass. Nigga, I ain't playing with you. This ain't no threat. This is a promise. Try me, motherfucker. My white friend would turn to me offended like, dude, what the fuck?
Fuck.
She can't do that, man. This is your space. This is your area. She's violating your right to privacy. You should say something. You want me to go say something? I'd be so scared. I start talking to him like a slave from Roots. Like, he's gonna get me's in trouble. Mm-hmm. My mother smacked the shit out of the white boy.
genius.
Is Carell, is Carell not your last name?
Not originally.
What is it, Pinocchio?
Okay. Okay.
Like when you go to the beach and someone yells.
I've been in a room with lots of smart people where Joe was in the same room, and it wasn't obvious that he wasn't the smartest person in the room. So, you know, he's one of those characters who's not, he's not a formal intellectual, but often really smart people who have taught themselves. And Joe is a, he's a remarkable guy. I mean, you think he's tough as a boot. That's the first thing. He's a fighter. That takes a lot of bravery. He's damn funny, like pro-level funny. His net and often viciously funny. The thing he did on the Kardashians, that was just, man, I just couldn't believe that he would go that far. It was just my jaw just kept opening more and more as he became more and more of, like, he was this, like, what gargoyle on a bedpost, right, whispering in Jenner's ear. Yeah, God, very politically incorrect, very funny. And he's very brave.
How many blunts do you smoke in a day?
I smoke 2 ounces, like 2 ounces a day.
But if you had to put it in a ratio of blunts, like, see how I brought 4 blunts out here and we smoked one, and then I'm smoking another, that's 2.
So look, okay, look. An ounce for me in blunts is like a whole pack of wood, so that's 5 blunts.
You smoke a whole fucking ounce with 5 blunts?
If I had my assistant here, he's supposed to came here. If I had him, I'd be able to show you right now.
Slow down, brother. You could get 10 out of that, man.
But I had 2 ounces.
I love it. I fucking love it.
Yo, check.
Getting crazy.
How many blunts do you...
Yo, check this. 50. See what else we got?
Yeah. Fucking genius.
Getting crank called on 1 hour sleep, 3, 4, 5 in the morning. That exposes.
So the tax.
What's the easiest way to make money?
The first million is the hardest to make.
Right. Yeah.
So start with the second million.
Right.
Hello. It was supposed to be funny, guys. Come on, wake up.
And it makes a big difference to tell the American people the truth about what our options are in ending this war. If tomorrow the order goes out from the president, I'm president of the United States, I issue an order, end the war today, begin to withdraw all American troops. It will take a year to get the American troops out. Do you hear me now? That's the truth. It will take a year to get them physically out. Now, if you leave all the equipment behind, you might be able to do it in 7 months. And you leave those billions of dollars of weapons behind, I promise they're going to be used against your grandchild and mine someday. So, and it makes a big difference to tell the American people the truth about what our options are in ending this war.
What was that amount that you've seen, the biggest check that you've seen?
In one piece?
Like, yeah.
It was like, I don't even want to say that.
No, say it, 50. Come on, man. It's not for me. It's
throw
for
back
the,
down now.
No kids.
I got over my entire time with RBK, I got about $80 million out of
it. You left because you weren't healthy. When did you start to feel better? And
I have voices in my head. They counsel me. They understand.
They went down the street was because they didn't know that it was all black ice. The whole street was black ice. And we sat on the roof, and there was not a goddamn thing we could do.
Wait, how many black guys?
No.
I said to my son, what word starts with E, ends with E, but only has one letter in it? He said, I, duh. I said, no. Dummy. Envelope. I said to my son, what word starts with E, ends with E, but only has one letter in it? He said, I, duh. I said, no. Dummy. Envelope.
I said, they took the kids that really liked to draw, and they started giving them little gold stars on their drawings.
And then they like the gold stars. For a kid, that's an extrinsic reward. And then they stop doing that, and the kids stop drawing. They associate the good feeling of doing it with the external rewards. Right. We have to be very cautious about how much of our internal dopamine we attach to external rewards if we want to continue to grow and pursue and focus and work hard. They took the kids that...
Are you married?
What?
Are you...
When she says she wants to try out toys, folks.
So all you niggas, whites and browns, dinners, tacuaches. See, I'm Mexican, I can say it with some niggas.
Que pasa, wey?
Que pasa, vato? You sound like shit. So all you niggas, whites and browns, dinners, tacuaches.
See, I'm Mexican, I can say it with some niggas.
Somebody tried to boom. Geld im Frisk, ich am Donnerstag, mich auf der Mauer. Geld im Frisk, ich am Donnerstag, mich auf der Mauer. Geld im Frisk.
Somebody tried to bull me, I'll show up at your fucking house and kill you.
Hold on, let me handle this.
Problem. The zero gravity on the way to Mars is not too much of a problem because people have actually shown that they can live for over a year in zero gravity. Your bones do get a little thinner, but they come back and they're walking around, they're doing fine. So I think.
Boy, what the fuck is those, boy? You dumb son. Boy, what the fuck is those, boy? You dumb
son. I'm not a fighter, I'm a lover.
I don't know, no, because if you're a lover, you gotta be a fighter.
How so?
Because if you don't fight for your love, what kind of love do you have? No, I'm kidding.
People get uptight whenever I talk about porn. I don't know why. It's right there. How could you not watch porno? It's right there. It's like right on your computer. How could you not watch it? Like if two people were having sex right here, and I was telling jokes right here, how many of you would be looking at me? Nobody. It's right there. It's not a weird thing. Like, I get why people watch love stories. I get why you'd watch like a romantic.
Hey mom, what's the difference between a light bulb and a pregnant woman?
What, Jesse?
You can unscrew a light bulb. Hey mom, what's the difference between a light bulb and a pregnant woman?
What, Jesse?
You can unscrew a light bulb. Hey mom, what's the difference between a light bulb and a pregnant woman?
Jesse.
You can unscrew a light bulb.
Switch it up. Switch it up.
Tell me you're single without telling me you're single. I'll go first.
If this man is single, we're fucked.
Tell me you're single without telling me you're single. I'll go first.
If this man is single, we're fucked.
Tell me you're single without...
Memang kurang ajar, ini bawa matalaya dulu sini. Something.
Speak English.
Fuck you. Memang kurang ajar, ini bawa matalaya dulu sini. Something.
Speak English.
Fuck you. Memang kurang ajar.
Excuse me, ma'am. Excuse me, ma'am.
I have a boyfriend.
Okay, that's great. I just want to let you know that your tire's flat.
Will you mind helping me?
First,
take a big step back and literally fuck your own face.
Get your fucking boyfriend to do it.
I love this.
Excuse me, ma'am.
I have a boyfriend.
Okay, that's great. I just want to let you know that your tire's flat.
Will you mind helping me?
Will you mind helping me?
First, take a big step back and literally fuck your own face!
Oh, genius. Folks, genius.
Hey Dad, think fast.
Listen, that child is going to be a pro athlete.
All
right, so you guys are all trashing, you know, what the government's doing with taxes and all these programs. But, you know, surely the government has to tax and do something. So, you know, what should the government be doing? Should the government totally cease to exist? What do you think?
John Allison?
Well, I think the government has a very important role. First, its real fundamental role is to protect individual rights, to make sure that Peter doesn't steal from Paul. And it does that in a variety of ways. One, it has to have a strong military to protect the United States from foreign powers. We need a strong police force to prevent people from stealing from each other. And we need a strong court system that defends individual rights, defends property rights, and settles legitimate disputes. So government is very important. It just needs to do the right things, not redistribute wealth from the productive and give to the non-productive.
All right, so you guys are all trashing, you know, what the government's doing with taxes and all these programs, but, you know, surely the government has to tax and...
Who pays on a first date?
Who pays?
Who pays on the first date?
Whoever idea it was to go on a date.
Amen.
Who pays?
People come up to me and they're like, oh, your voice doesn't match your face. And I'm like... What did you expect me to sound like? You thought I'd be like, oh, give me the $2.50 and I give you the kimchi hoya. People come up to me and they're like, oh, your voice doesn't match your face. And I'm like, what did you expect me to sound like? You thought I'd be like, oh, give me the $2.50 and I give you the kimchi hoya. People come up to me and they're like, oh, your voice doesn't match your face. And I'm like, what did you expect me to sound like? You thought I'd be like, oh, give me the $2.50 and I give you the kimchi hoya. People come up to me and they're like, oh, your voice doesn't match your face. And I'm like, what did you expect me to sound like? You thought I'd be like, oh, give me the $2.50 and I give you the kimchi hoya. People come up to me and they're like, oh, your voice doesn't match your face. And I'm like, what did you expect me to sound like? You thought I'd be like, oh, give me the $2.
You give an ugly guy a chance, he thinks he rules the world.
You give a depressed girl some autotune, she thinks she can sing.
Yo, that one there was a violin.
You give an ugly guy a chance.
Did you know that there are more airplanes in the ocean than there are submarines in the air?
Well, that's plain to see. I wonder what kind of doctor Dr. Pepper was.
Physician.
I haven't got an attitude with anybody except you, Steven. Distance yourself. You cross this line, we're gonna have a problem.
Fuck your line.
Fuck you.
Hey, y'all chill, man.
God damn, dude. I knew from the fucking very first fucking minute I met you, you were gonna be a fucking problem. Stay away from me, unless we're working together up in the tower or something.
If you're chasing the Twitch affiliate status, I would like to say pump the brakes.
If I can flip for you on stage, could you offer me an internship?
No. When you give with expectation in return, you lose. Especially when you're asking for something as big time as an internship at Vayner that has become super competitive.
Yeah.
That's when you've got to do your homework of what the value is. It's awesome that you can do a flip. I feel like you were going to win twice. You were going to do rad ass flip on stage and get an internship. That's not only giving with.
I can't help noticing also that everybody wants to take our guns away, surrounded by guys with guns. I mean, I used to live next door to one of the biggest stars in Hollywood and one of the biggest anti-gun crusaders in Hollywood as yep. well. All day long, these guys were going in with the go bags to protect her house and keep her from being, you know, attacked. They called my house and said, by the way, we're watching your house too. And I thought, great, now the biggest anti-gun advocate in Hollywood has enough guns to protect my house. That's great, but when she moved away, I wanted a gun of my own just to keep safe, you know? So it's like, I think that it is amazing how elite people lose touch with the fact that the rest of us can't surround ourselves with bodyguards and would just like to be safe. I can't help noticing.
You're the worst looking cast member in I Am Legend.
And what is that, bro?
If you go to the gym and you work out and you come back and you look in the mirror, you will see nothing. And if you go to the gym the next day and you come back and you look in the mirror, you will see nothing. So clearly there's no results, can't be measured, it must not be effective. So we quit. Or if you fundamentally believe that this is the right course of action and you stick with it, you commit yourself to an act of service. You commit yourself to the regime, the exercise. You can screw it up. You can eat chocolate cake one day, you can skip a day or two. But if you stick with it consistently, I'm not exactly sure what day, but I know you'll start getting into shape. Going to the gym for 9 hours does not get you into shape. Working out every day for 20 minutes gets you into shape. It's not about the events. It's not about intensity. It's about consistency. If you go to the gym.
No. No. No.
Not sign the other bills though, so some of these workers can get paid. The government.
You
get
think I should do that?
Yeah, you got.
No, no. Do you think I should do that, John?
Well, I mean, it's not for me
I
to
mean,
say that.
I want your one-sided reporting. Do you think I should do that?
It's
John.
My daughter, who's in preschool, has a little period of time where the parents come and they hang out with the kid in the morning. This is last year, and this little boy Nicholas sat across the table from her, and I was coloring with her and doing the things you do with a preschool child.
Absolutely.
And he looked up at me and he said, "Are you the Hulk?" And I'm like, "Well, no." And my daughter's like, "Yeah, he's the Hulk." And he said, "Can you turn into the Hulk?" And I was like, she's like, "Do it, Daddy, do it." So I went, and he went, My daughter, who's in preschool, has a little.
Dan, you got the money, okay?
Mr. Trump, I wanted to.
Yeah, check this out. Yeah, sounds killer. That sounds dope.
Sounds great.
Yeah, check this out.
Nice. You will be told your whole life that you need to learn to listen. I would say that you need to learn to be the last to speak. I see it in boardrooms every day of the week. Even people who consider themselves good leaders, who may actually be decent leaders, will walk into a room and say, "Here's the problem, here's what I think, but I'm interested in your opinion, let's go around the room." It's too late. The skill to hold your opinions to yourself until everyone has spoken does two things. One, it gives everybody else the feeling that they have been heard. It gives everyone else the ability to feel that they have contributed. And two, you get the benefit of hearing what everybody else has to think before you render your opinion. The skill is really to keep your opinions to yourself. If you agree with somebody, don't nod yes. If you disagree with somebody, don't nod no. Simply sit there, take it all in, and the only thing you're allowed to do is ask questions so that you can understand what they mean. You will be told your whole life that you need to learn to listen.
If you want to be wealthy, and happy the rest of your life, just learn this lesson well. He said, learn to work harder on yourself than you do on your job. If you want to be wealthy.
The fucking world is $281 trillion in debt. To who?
To me. I'm a businessman.
The fucking world.
Breaking news. Stores are running out of tampons due to the rise of pussies in this country. Yo, this guy's 100% right. Breaking news.
High performance people fly like eagles. Eagles fly alone. Zuckerberg has no mates. Elon Musk has no mates. Steve Jobs had no mates. Bill Gates has no mates. And I can go on and on and on and on. They don't hang, they don't chill, they don't go to the Super Bowl, they don't go to the World Cup, they don't go to Wimbledon. All they do is work.
Like, yeah, you work.
How come you ain't never liked me? What law is there say I got to like you?
None.
All right then. Don't you eat every day? Answer me when I talk to you. You eat every day.
Yes, sir.
Got a roof over your head.
Yes, sir.
Got clothes on your back.
Yes, sir.
Why you think that is?
Because of you.
Hell, I know it's because of me, but why do you think that is?
Because you like me?
Like you. I go out of here every morning. I bust my butt putting up with them crackers every day because I like you. You're about the biggest fool I ever saw. It's my job. It's my responsibility. A man is supposed to take care of his family. You live in my house, fill your belly with my food, put you behind on my bed because you're my son. Because I like you, because it's my duty to take care of you. I owe a responsibility to you. I ain't got to like you. Now, don't you go through life worrying about whether somebody like you or not. You best be making sure they're doing right by you.
How come you ain't never like me?
What law?
You don't want some filthy... I've worked with the Navy SEALs, and I asked them, how do you pick, like, the guys that go on SEAL Team 6? Because they're the best of the best, the best of the best. They drew a graph for me, and on one side, they wrote the word performance, and on the other side, they wrote the word trust. The way they put it is, I may trust you with my life, but do I trust you with my money and my wife? They're SEALs. This is what they told me. Nobody wants this person, the low performer of low trust, of course. Of course, everybody wants this person, the high performer of high trust. What they learned is that this person, the high performer of low trust, is a toxic leader and a toxic team member. And they would rather have a medium performer of high trust, sometimes even a low performer of high trust, it's a relative scale, over this person. This is the highest performing organization on the planet, and this person is more important than this person. And the problem in business, we have a million and one metrics to measure someone's performance, and negligible to no metrics to measure someone's trustworthiness, which is bad for the long game, because it eventually destroys the whole organization. I've worked with the Navy SEALs, oh, and I asked them...
Did you ever find out who did it?
Yeah, I knew who did it shortly after.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And they are now where?
Oh, the guy who actually shot me is dead.
In the Bible, it says, what goes around comes around.
Do you want a bite?
Sooner or later, there comes a point in a man's life...
Mom, Dad, the teacher doesn't like me. And my mom and dad would say, who gives a fuck?
Are there words that are used to describe men?
I told my kids the other day, I said,
I'd like to
market inspirational videos. Give me some comedy, folks.
This hype man.
I very frequently.
My grandfather walked.
What do you think is the number one thing?
She was like, I found a nice house, but has no furnitures. And I'm like, but then you go to IKEA and you get the furnitures. And then the broker goes like, rich people, they don't buy furnitures in IKEA. No, but intelligent people do. That's my story.
Ma'am, I'm sorry, your license is invalid.
Metro to T1, checking on you.
Says you weigh 135.
Just so you know, 40% of all the money ever printed in America was printed in the last 12 months. Let me say one more time, please listen. Please listen to.
Well, I want it. You're trespassing on my.
Are you 5'2"?
Absolutely not. 5'4". 5'3". 5'3".
Kevin.
5'2½".
Are you 5'2"?
Absolutely not. 5'4". 5'3".
My culture meant a great pride in doing physical labor.
No, where's the goalkeeper going? Make your fucking goal!
I'm gonna tell you guys how Eminem predicted the future with the song Stan. Y'all remember when Eminem brought up Stan's little brother, Matthew? He's the one that was only 6 years old and waited outside for him in the blistering cold for 4 hours and he still said no. And in 2013, we had a song called Bad Guy, which was the perspective of Matthew talking to Eminem. And in the third verse, Matthew talks about breaking into Eminem's house so he could get revenge for Stan. Now, this is where the story weirdly clicks. And says,
allowing us to come into your training facility.
Thank you for having fun.
No problem.
I just disappeared. Allowing us to come into your training facility.
Thank you for having fun.
No problem.
I just disappeared.
What are the chances of this?
I'm just wondering whether you remember the Derby match in 1967 at Goodison, FA Cup, fifth round, and it was shown on a big screen at Anfield at the
same time.
That's right. Do you remember it?
Yeah, I do. I played in it.
Did you?
I was goalkeeper for Liverpool.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, well, that's a stroke of luck, me meeting you. Yeah. Yeah. Sorry, can you remind me of your name?
Tommy Lawrence.
Tommy, nice to meet you. What do you remember about it?
It was a great game, yeah. Alan Ball scored the winner.
Did indeed.
Yeah, he did, yeah.
What are the chances of this?
I'm just wondering whether you remember the Derby match in 1967 at Goodison, FA Cup, fifth round, and it was shown on a big screen at Anfield at the
same
time.
That's right.
Do you remember it?
Yeah, I do. I played in it.
Did you?
I was goalkeeper for Liverpool.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, well, that's a stroke of luck, me meeting you. Yeah. Yeah. Sorry, can you remind me of your name?
Tommy Lawrence.
Tommy, nice to meet you. What do you remember about it?
It was a great game, yeah. Alan Ball scored the winner.
Did indeed.
Look how happy this man is that he can talk about it.
Yeah, I did, yeah.
What are the chances?
What do you think, Puff? It's a fucking tool.
Hear me out.
We never drop one rice on the.
A lot of people work really, really hard for.
Better that bite is. This guy's one of the best predators in the wild. When he actually sees something he wants to eat, very. Better that.
I'm not gonna charge you, but I got a question for you.
Okay.
What do you call a policeman in bed? Undercover cop.
You're going to.
To enjoy good health, to bring true happiness to one's family, to bring peace to all, one must.
My hair, cause with my hair like this, I look like my name is Andy.
What?
What's up, shorties?
What did you say?
What's up, shorties?
Nice.
Where's your brother?
What?
Where's your brother?
Andrew?
Yes.
I don't know.
Look what he left.
I don't know.
Where's your brother?
She know?
Nice. What the hell? So sweet.
Girlfriend?
No, I don't.
Are you gay?
I'm not gay. Except my boyfriend is gay.
You got a girlfriend?
No, I don't.
Are you gay?
I'm not gay. Except my boyfriend is gay.
You got a girlfriend?
This iPhone 13, but I want it back in a year, okay? Random, but okay.
If he wants it back in a year, I guess I could sell it now for $1,000, and then when Apple inevitably comes out with the iPhone 14, they'll discount this model. I'll buy it back for $600, thus I'll profit $400.
Hey, how's it going? Do you have that iPhone 13? Yeah, but to be honest, I sold it the day you gave it to me knowing the price would go down, and then I bought it back again now that it's cheaper. So you borrowed my iPhone, and when it came to returning it, you bought it back for less than what you sold it for, so you made a profit on me. Yeah, I guess. Then you've learned the lesson, my son. What lesson? I just showed you what shorting a stock is. You borrow a share of a stock, and when it comes to returning it, if you can buy it back for less, you make a profit. If not, you'll take a loss. That took a year for you to explain? No, it took about 45 seconds, which is the length of this video. You better follow me now. Jeez. I'm gonna give you this.
Empty. 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 Empty.
Jesus Christ, folks.
That guy hit the fly,
it's
acceptable.
He could have asked for it as well.
That's kind of usual toilet.
That's classic. Guys, what am I doing? This is so on me. If you want, I'll do it.
Jesus Christ!
If that guy hit the flies,
Archie's Beats.
Nigga wanna see me fall.
The camera. Say hello.
I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. I take a look at my life and realize there's nothing left. Cause I've been blasting and laughing so long that even my mama thinks that my mind is gone.
lost a man that didn't deserve.
Cassie, say puppies before every word.
Okay. Puppies, puppies, puppies about.
Uh-huh.
Puppies talked. Puppies eye. Puppies long. Puppies how. Puppies look.
Good. Now say it after every word.
Puppies, puppies, about puppies, talked puppies, eye puppies, long puppies, how puppies look, puppies.
Good. And now I'll say puppies before every word, but going from the bottom to the top.
Puppies look, puppies how, puppies long, puppies
struggling.
Eye, puppies talk, puppies about, puppies, puppies.
Okay. Now read from the bottom to the top without saying any extra words.
Look how long I talked about puppies.
Cassie.
I seriously have no idea. I seriously have no idea.
Dwayne, get.
Okay, folks. Now that's it for today. Enough. If you like this, let me know, and see you next time, folks.